Hi guys, Andre from Conveyor of Randomness here, and today I'll be asking how good is the cheapest video capture card on Amazon? As online streaming becomes increasingly popular, it's important to have equipment that is going to be fit for purpose. If you're into streaming games and play on either a console or a second PC that is separate from your streaming PC, then you're going to need a device that is going to project what you're playing on the console through your TV or PC, and that's where the video capture card comes in. It takes the picture and audio from your game, brings it into the input device, usually a PC, and allows you to live record and stream what you're playing through software such as OBS onto streaming platforms such as Twitch and YouTube. If you're streaming direct from your PlayStation or Xbox, you're often limited with the customization of the look of your stream, but putting the feed through your capture card and subsequently onto OBS, and you're given all the customization that you need. This is the cheapest HDMI video capture card that you'll find on Amazon. The thing is, it comes in so many different guises at various prices between £7 and £30, and in loads of slightly differing external wording on the device itself. But at the end of the day, they're all the same capture card, probably built on the same conveyor belt in the same factory in China, just slapped with a different label at the end of the manufacturing process. All of these companies essentially selling the same product within the same budget price range. At this price, it can't be any good, can it? Put capture card into Amazon and you'll find the big hitters like the Elgato HD60, which is seen as one of the industry must-haves, and the one I'll be comparing to spec-wise. But dotted in between all those high-end capture cards, you'll find these budget capture cards as well. So let's look at the essential specs. It can support input of up to 4K and output of 1080p. So if you're going to want to display crisp-looking 4K content, then you're going to have to spend a little bit more money. But if you're just getting started, then 1080 is still going to provide you with good quality pictures, although you will have to make do with 30 frames per second at 1080 compared to the 60 frames per second with the cheapest Elgato. But if you do drop down to 720, then you can reach that 60fps. It supports 8, 10 and 12 bit deep color, so there's not going to be many shades outside the three primary colors that this capture card isn't going to be able to replicate as output to your stream. After tweaking the input settings, it's generally a plug and play device, as you can connect it with any device with a HDMI interface. It's compatible with Windows, macOS and Android. While the Elgato utilizes the speeds of USB 3.0, this capture card still persists with the slower USB 2.0. The capture card attaches directly to your computer via its USB interface, compared to the Elgato and other capture cards, which act as intermediaries between your input device, like your games console or PC, and your streaming device with USB. Often USB-C, taking the HDMI signal and converting it to a digital signal that can be interpreted and processed. As I like to view what I'm playing on a large TV and have what I see streamed to the PC, I'm going to need a little bit of an extra piece of kit for that. I've got a HDMI splitter, which can be purchased quite cheaply, that sits in between the console and the capture card, allowing the HDMI signal to be split into two outputs rather than one. So I've got a picture going from not only the console to the capture card, but also to the TV. So let's go and see this video capture card in action. So that was the video capture card in action. That was a demonstration of what the video card is capable of as opposed to the quality of the stream. As you can see, it's capable of providing that link between your games console or PC and your streaming device. As you could probably tell from the demonstration, I'm not a fan of the angle that the capture card sits in when it's attached to the computer. When the HDMI cable is attached, it's putting unwarranted stress on the USB side of the card. If anything on the device were to break first, I'm sure it most likely would be this. And what would correct this? Just a little subtle design change. By the end of my test stream, the capture card was noticeably warm, but it didn't seem to have any effect on performance. The capture card does a good job, and you certainly get more for your money with this capture card, no matter which version you buy. And together with the right hardware and accessories, then you're going to be happy with the results that you get from this. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to the channel. It'd be greatly appreciated and it would help the growth of the channel. And press the bell icon to get notified every time I release a new video. That's all for me today. I'll see you on the next one. Bye. Why don't you go and watch one of these two videos before the time runs out? 3, 2, 1.